Hello and welcome to the non-Greg Strillis show, except only the substitutes. I am your host, the Pamazon. That is I. Yes. And yes, it is.
I thought I was going to go to the kitten. Hello. This is me. I am not.
Speak
the
up,
kitten.
Son. Use that microphone.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, I'm very excited. Borat 2 is coming out after like 15 years. Very nice.
Make oral love to that microphone, son.
Hey, Mr. Ski Mask. We're trying to teach John the microphone skills.
Yeah.
But you get that black member in your face like you like it, son.
I think it would just, like, kill you.
Nice and close to your lips.
The microphone will not
like
kill you.
Like Lips Incorporated in their hit song Funky Town.
Oh my gosh, covered that song so many times in so many bands, surprisingly.
I figured that out on my phone buttons.
Did
once.
You?
And I figured it out on this new phone, but I figured it out on... I was so excited, I would just sit there and do it for like ever if I was bored.
It's a catchy song.
How about Barf? Barfalo is like Chunky Town because everybody's fat from eating wings and pizza and watching the Bills and sitting on their keister.
Pizza and wings are delicious.
Right? Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, they are. And watching the Barfalo Bills is delicious and not a waste of time.
I do watch
Do they have
them.
Good pizza and wings in Hawaii? I never really thought of that.
We got great wings. Reinvented wings in Hilo. And then Barfalo stole the idea.
I don't believe it.
Those damn
I don't believe it.
Cronies and pineapples. Yeah, they're Hilo wings. Son.
That sounds pretty good. What kind of pizza you guys have?
Pineapple.
Blasphemous pineapple.
The blasphemous pineapple. Not just the regular pineapple pizza, but the blasphemous pineapple.
Speaking of blasphemous, I'm wearing my red shirt for a twofold reason.
Why is the twofold?
First off, the first reason is the broodmare bimbo Becky Barrett, who is going to destroy our nation in the Supreme Court. She was wearing a red handmaiden's dress at her last hearing.
And you know what else she wore?
Second.
Go ahead. Sorry.
Second reason, Edward Van Halen, hero to cis white boys everywhere, just passed.
That is true.
And he had a red guitar.
He did.
Like the red guitar 2000 at yahoo.com on WJJ.
Elvis.
Where was Eddie from?
Just
was
me
he
and
from
the dog.
Like Sweden or something? He was from Denmark, some weird place.
Who? Van Halen?
Yeah, I forget what country he was from.
What country?
Indonesia.
Yeah, he was half Indonesian and half Swedish or something.
Okay.
So Earl Campbell, he's from
Dale
he's
Campbell,
from WJJ. He's from
2003 yahoo.com.
Where was Frederick Mercury from? He was from somewhere strange.
Hey.
So Amy Poehler
Melissa Campbell's father?
What about her father?
I think it's her cousin.
Her father's the red guitar.
Yeah.
Earl Campbell.
Duke, no, you're thinking of the Duke of Earl. The Duke of Drive. Earl.
I'm thinking about the Duke of Meatballs. The Prince of Pasta.
Prince of Pasta.
Letty
the boss
Rico.
With the spaghetti sauce.
Yes. Well, do you want to address... I think we should address Edward Van Halen first, because that'll be easier. And then we will move to the broodmare on the Supremacist Court.
Yes, go ahead. Eddie Van Halen was great. As me and you both know, there's people like fighting about who's the best guitarist, which was really ridiculous on the Facebooks. There's a lot of good guitarists.
One thing
people.
I know, did you ever notice the only black guitarist that white boys know of is Jimi Hendrix? Unless maybe Vernon Reid from The Living Color. They do not know. They do not respect and know Ernie Isley, one of the best guitarists ever, from the Isley Brothers, from their 3+3 album onward. And how about Nile Rodgers, who plays a distinctive and delightful funk-style guitar? White boys don't like that.
I mean, Prince was a very great guitarist, and so was Curtis Mayfield.
Yes, he was. Yes.
Curtis Mayfield also great. Yeah, people have a very narrow bandwidth, and then they fight about their narrow bandwidth and claim that to be the best. My tiny person in my narrow itty-bitty bandwidth must be the best.
Well, if it's not a tiny...
You know what I like? I like the pizza boxes. The pizza boxes in Buffalo that say you've tried all the rest, now try the best. Our pizza is the greatest.
That's very confident.
Like Eddie Van Halen. Yes.
I mean, you know, Eddie Van Halen was fun. He was a fun guitarist. But there's a lot of great guitarists, you know? I don't know.
How about female guitarists like April Lawton from the early 70s from Ramatam, which featured the drummer of the Jimi Hendrix Experience.
Yes.
She was so good that people used to say that she was a dude who had a sex change and she can't really be a woman. And they gave her all kinds of grief and stuff. And she just gave up and quit doing music.
Elizabeth Buckingham's like she's like the most...
She's great.
She's the best doom metal player out there. She's probably... Other than Tony Iommi.
Get on the microphone.
Oh, sorry.
We will train you.
We're going to have to peg you, son.
I mean,
get on that microphone.
I mean, I don't know. I love Elizabeth Buckingham. She's not my favorite doom metal guitarist, but I think she's most people's favorites. I think I like Matt Pike better, but...
Yeah. Oh, no. I mean, there's like a lot of women that were founded like guitar styles that men are now lauded for.
Yeah. You were postulating about that before.
I was, because I was like, fuck this nonsense. And I love Jimi Hendrix. Yeah, Mother Maybelle Carter, Elizabeth Cotton, Sister Rosetta Thorpe, Joni Mitchell did all the different tunings in the finger picking.
Penelope.
So,
speaking of Joni Mitchell, people are bitching about her good friend, Dudley's hero, David Crosby. They asked David Crosby what he thought about Edward Van Halen, and he said, meh, because he's not really into Edward Van Halen, and everybody's getting mad.
Well, he said Jimi Hendrix was the best, and to me, it just seemed like intergenerational testosterone fueled pissing match, you know?
It is. It's like how I have no
respect.
Being from the Being from the old school hardcore and punk scene, I really had no feeling or affinity for any of the Seattle bands of the 90s, like Pearl Jam or Alice in Chains or Nirvana. None of that shit meant anything to me. So I can understand where Mr. Crosby might be coming from. In a way.
In a way, I mean, I don't know. It's just...
It's a generational thing.
That's all that matters.
But it doesn't... I mean, it's... So there was this article going around, and it said, Kraftwerk invented everything. And I hated it. Whenever I saw it, I would fight whoever posted. Whoever posted it, I would fight them, because they're like, they invented the drum machines and pop rock. And I was like, oh my God. There is Bruce Hack.
No, you know what?
Go ahead.
Yeah. Kraftwerk were the masters of the real folk blues. They have swagger that would make Mick Jagger jealous. Those are the two aspects of Kraftwerk I admire most.
Their swagger?
Their rock and roll swagger.
Mm-hmm.
And the other thing I said, my memory is shot.
But they surely did not invent the genre of electronic pop music.
They invented the real folk blues. Yes.
People were saying that they...
As imitated by Mudwater and the Wolf That Howls from the chessboard.
Yes, there was plenty of other people before them. And some of them are still around. Go ahead.
The system in America can't work. Millions of lives will be ruined, destroyed, obliterated, or said to not exist because of one psychotic cult member, broodmare, being on the Supreme Court. What sense does it make that millions of lives for decades and generations will be affected by one lunatic who still believes in an imaginary crazy sky monster that you have to appease every Sunday?
Or that the ways that these people think you would appease this Magical Sky got are ridiculous. Like, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that is absolutely terrifying. My friend had pointed out she wore a blue dress one day, and the blue dress is of the privileged wives in The Handmaid's Tale. So she wants to move up from a handmaid to the privileged wife
move on
the Supreme Court.
Yes.
Move on, yeah. Up, yeah. Curtis Mayfield, I love Curtis Mayfield. He's so good. And there's this band, you probably know this band, The Undisputed Truth.
Oh, I love them, yes.
They're so good. They're really great. They're a great, like, kind of proggy funk band. Really good.
Yeah, I have like 10 of their albums.
Yeah, they're so good. They're really great. Yeah, so, yeah, it's definitely very terrifying. And then, you know, there's still people fighting with me on my Facebook about the poor babies were slaughtering people. And, like, you don't care. Like, they're in cages at the border with no medical with no medical care dying. And you said the Bible is pro-abortion anyways.
Yeah, at least with the bitter water.
The bitter water, yes. The bitter water of the Bible.
Yes. Bitter Trump voters.
Yeah.
On my face mask book.
Trying to force people's
religion is just nothing but republicanism anyway.
Yeah, they don't really.
She hit.
I put that quote, it's, you know, the one about being easier to get a camel through the eye of a needle than a rich man in heaven. All these Christian people were like, that's not in the Bible. I was like, what? Like, that's like famous. That's a famous one. I don't know a shit ton about the Bible. I know that one. It's a famous one. Where have you been? Go ahead.
Here's something that ties in everything together. The broodmare popped out 5 biological children. Mm-hmm. And that's too many. She's being irresponsible, overpopulating, taking resources away from spotted owls and polar bears, which us libtards love. And she is also, destroying resources by overbreeding.
Yes.
Now, the only thing you should have 5 of would be like guitars, like Edward Van Halen.
Hey, how's your new
or
guitar?
Synthesizers.
How's your new guitar?
Still plus delightful.
I know. You said
it's
was amazing.
It's not here right now. I don't have it with me, but yes.
Awesome. Yes, you can have multiple synthesizers. So,
yeah. Eddie Van Halen had multiple synthesizers. Every synthesizer is a wanted synthesizer.
They should be, at least.
They're so delightful.
What did he play?
Thing.
Do you know what his?
He had an Oberheim.
Oh, jeez.
It's a big ass Oberheim. Oh,
that's a nice one. Oh.
Why can't this be Glove?
Oh man.
Why can't this be Glove?
Oh, that'd be nice to have. I have no Oberheims.
I love Oberheims. I would like an Oberheim as well.
You don't have one either?
No. Yeah. I had an Oberheim Phasor pedal for a while.
Yeah.
But that was the only Oberheim thing I had.
I think, did Greg have one at one time?
I think he did.
I think he did too.
He had a little one. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Greg always goes through lots of synths and all the time. He had one of my favorites, the Krumar. I love the Krumars. Krumar.
How about the White Boys?
What about those White Boys?
Acknowledge the guitar playing part of Edward Van Halen and ignore the synthesizer part, because that's what white boys like.
It's true. That is their thing.
Oh, like when I used to go to those guitar shows at Hearthstone Manor.
Yeah.
Those playing crappy 50th generation white boy blues on a Les Paul through a distortion pedal.
I was playing a show at Mohawk. I got off the stage and this guy came up to me and he said, you know, that was okay, but I could really teach you to play, you know, so you know the blues.
Oh,
I was like, get the fuck out of here.
In fact, I'm going to tell you something unpopular that's true.
Okay.
Fuzz pedals are better than distortion pedals. Compressor pedals are better than distortion pedals.
Oh.
Both fuzz and compression pedals are better than Mesa Boogie triple rectified amplification.
Oh, okay. How do you know
that stock distortion tone is very boring?
Yeah.
puts me to sleep. I can't even listen to it anymore.
How do you know the difference between the fuzz and distortion? I know it sounds dumb, but I just kind of play my pedals and figure out what I like.
Fuzz is more tweezy, more and it cuts through the mix and it like blasts your ears in the most delightful way.
Okay.
And distortion is more like that stock sound that all the lame-ass pseudo-hard rock bands that all sound alike go for.
I have the MXR, the Metal Machine. That's probably...
Of course you do.
Is that...
You're a metal master, like the Arion pedal.
Yes, that one's very fun. Yeah, I don't know. I just like it because I can easily dial in a lot of that distortion that's soft but cuts out, you know, that like goes bzzz, and then like when you stop, it stops.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the sound I like.
I'm sure you're not using distortion the way it's intended to be used.
Probably not.
That is. To put people to sleep.
Yeah. I also used to have a rat pedal, which I liked a lot, but it died.
Oh, I had a rat too.
Yeah, they
rat
sound...
Rat is the food of the future. We're going to be eating rat straight out of the dumpster. Not rat out of the cellar, but out of the dumpster. Because we're going to have 4 more years of the Trumpster.
No, I thought it's that silent drink that you get advertisements on the face mask book.
Which drink? Jesus pizza?
Silent brown.
No, it's bugs. We're going to be eating bugs.
Soylent Byron Brown?
Byron
Soylent Brown.
He's in trouble. He's politically in trouble. He's been a little...
What did he do this time?
Oh, he's just not... You know, he's just been not proactive with all the things that have happened in Buffalo in regards to the police and brutality and stuff like that.
He should go have a drink and iron out things and smooth things over down at the empty pockets.
But he doesn't.
Oh,
do
he
that.
Could have a beer summit.
A beer summit at empty pockets like Obama had with the Bud Light.
And the cop had a Heineken.
Yeah. And Barack Hussein Obama had the Bud Light. YFY. Try Bud Dry. It's like dry sex with no lube.
Ouch.
It's really good for your skin tube.
It's not good for your skin tube. Your skin tube hates that.
Skin tube, no lube. Every Trump voter is a rube. Oh, freestyling.
Or, yeah.
Freestyling.
Yeah. Now there's an awkward silence.
Well, we're waiting for it to restart, right? Oh, no, shit. It never restarted. I made that up. Sorry.
You're in the cosmic space couch.
I am in
You're in there
cosmic...
with David Crosby. You're in there with Jerry Garcia, who's sitting next to you over there.
All right. Who else is in there with me? Is there
the
someone I like in there?
For tobacco use only.
Is Ooh. There someone I like in there? I don't know.
Yeah, two. I already named them.
No,
David
I don't
Crosby.
Like
them.
I don't like him.
You don't like David Crosby? He's super delightful.
No,
he's got this great album.
What album? What
His
great
album.
Album.
If Which, only I could remember my name. The David Crosby solo album. Oh, it's great. I have like 5 copies of it.
Okay.
Hey, Jerry, you got that album?
I'll have. Hey, Dudley, can you ask Jerry if he's got that album?
I don't know. Jerry, wake up, Jerry.
Hey, Jerry.
Jerry. Oh, hi.
Oh, me? Hey. I'm Jerry.
Do you have that album?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. I didn't. What album?
Album.
Do you have the solo album of David Crosby?
I don't even know who David Crosby is.
If only I could remember my name.
Jerry, you forgot a lot.
Yeah, I don't even.
Remember Jerry had to reteach himself guitar when he was on some real bad acid trip and then he forgot how to play and then he taught himself how to play again?
Oh, that means he had some Dane bramage from that.
I mean, remember Dave Mustaine slept on his arm once wrong and he couldn't play his guitar for like years.
That's terrifying.
And
He slept on Jerry Garcia's arm?
Maybe. I know he slept on his own arm, but he got really bad nerve damage by accident, and he had to retrain for
That's
like 2 years.
That's sort of like when David David Bowie, like he slept on Mick Jagger's arm back in the good old days, the 70s, goat's head soup days. You know what I'm talking about, son. Dancing in the streets. They really meant dancing in the sheets and not like Klan supporter sheets like the Trump voters, not those sheets. The sheets on your bed, not the white sheets that Trump supporters wear on their head. It's 8 p.m., you get out the lead.
I have the Harlem Shuffle single on vinyl somewhere.
Oh, the Trump supporters are delighting. 45.
Bitch, it's a really good song.
We actually played that in the brass band that I was in. It made a strange brass arrangement, I thought, but you know, we did it.
Yeah, but there's brass in the real song.
There is, yeah. And it was really dark and I couldn't see my music and I begged someone to hold it up to my face. It's because I can't see far away.
I've always wanted one of those guitars made out of graphite.
Out of graphite? A graphite guitar?
That's what Jack Black's guitar is made out of.
Hmm.
You want a guitar made out of Masonite, son.
Okay.
Those are nice.
It's not like I could play anyway, but they look cool.
We had a 12-string Dan Electro. It had a specific name. It was the Belzuki. I don't know if you know that.
Ooh.
We had a Belzuki. Yes. And I played it in this band. I was in the Happy Purples. And then when the other bandmate, there was three of us, when one of the bandmates moved, he gave me everything, but he took the Belzuki, which is a really cool guitar. And let's see, there's one on Reverb right now, BELLZOUKI. And now it's worth like $2,000. I know you can't really see it, but you can.
Where did Ski Mask go?
Where'd he go? He's not in the.
He disappeared.
He didn't get sucked in the space pouch with you?
He might have.
Well, look around.
Let's see here.
Like, move some of that stuff away, out of the way, and take a look.
Whoa.
Is he in there?
What? Huh? Whoa. Huh? Whoa. Whoa.
Uh-oh. Yeah?
Hello? Whoa. What's going on here? Whoa. Whoa. Something strange going on.
No, that is true.
Oh, no.
No.
What's happening? Oh, my gosh. Hold on, John.
John.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry.
What is going on?
Oh, I don't know. There's probably something the kitten did.
That kitten. He's always messing up everything. Ooh, okay. Ooh. Well, we lost Ski Mask along that trip. But we're still here. So what was the guitar you saw that you liked?
No, I thought it was called a baby sitar, but now I'm confused. Cause
Dan Electro does make sitars as well.
But it wasn't a sitar. It was just a guitar with, like, sitar strings on it.
Yeah, they make guitar sitars.
Yeah, I was going to get it, but then I was like, yeah, I can't play a regular guitar, so why would I waste money on something that I can't play anyway?
Funny story. I saw that, too, and I as well wanted it. Yes, here's a whole bunch. Dan Electro guitar, sitars. Oh, there it is, baby sitar. See?
Yeah.
You weren't wrong.
Yeah, but then that guy kept, like, making fun of me because, like, I didn't understand something else he had for sale there, and I thought it was a guitar, and he was acting like I was an idiot.
Oh.
So I stopped going there for a really long time.
Well, okay. Was it?
It wasn't the owner, right?
No.
It wasn't the owner, yeah. Yeah.
I don't know who it was. I seen that guy like a few times before. He was a really older guy.
Hmm. Well, to heck with him.
Yeah, and then like, no, it wasn't the owner. I've never had a problem with the owner.
Yeah, he's really nice. Yeah, no, I remember they had that. They might still have it. I remember seeing it hanging there and really being like, that would be cool.
That was when it was on Elmwood because I used to.
I think they have another or they had another or something. I don't know. They're very cool, though, those little tiny Dan Electro sitars.
They're really the only music store I can even think of in Buffalo anymore.
In the city proper?
Yeah.
That's true. That's sad. Like,
I mean, there used to be more.
Like, what other ones were there in the city proper?
I used to go...
Chimes is in the city limits and theoretically still open.
Well, when Kmart was in Buffalo, I used to go to... Not the one in North Buffalo, but the one in South Buffalo. There used to be a music store there where I would go. But I don't remember what it was called.
What about the one in South... I think that's made it to West Seneca. Never mind. Chimes is still open in the city limits, but I think they're still open. And Allentown Music, I think that's it in the city.
Is Guitar Factory in Buffalo? No.
Oh, maybe that place in University Heights.
I don't know what that is.
That's a part of Buffalo. It's where UB is. That is the city proper. They might still be open too. Speak into your microphone.
Oh, sorry.
You are so negligent in your microphone skills.
I mean, I don't know. My dad has won a guitar in a contest that they only made 5 of, but at the time he thought acoustics were lame, so he just gave it away, which I thought was the dumbest thing ever.
Wow.
Because I forget what it was. I think it was Gibson had these... In the mid-90s, they were giving away their first completely laser-crafted guitars. And he just didn't want it, so he just gave it to his friend Jesse, which I thought was the dumbest thing ever. There was only 5 ever made, and you can only get them by winning the contest. And he won, and he's like, this is stupid.
That's kind of crazy.
It is insane. Don't just give it away.
I don't think I ever won any instrument ever. I mean, I've found some, and I've garbage picked some. I've never won any. How do you win it?
You could just go and fill out applications to apply to win in the contest, and he filled out. There was other prizes. There was like the main prize was like a lot of money, but that was like the secondary prize. But you could just fill out as many as you wanted. So he filled out like 1,000 of them, and he won the guitars.
Oh wow, cool. That's nice.
Yeah, I just entered us in some kind of contest. I don't remember what it was. I don't remember. I was at Feel Right.
I've only won one thing in my life, and I didn't enter the contest. My sister filled it out and put my name in the box. It was a giant pumpkin.
That's kind of cool, though.
It's not very cool.
I would be really excited. I would brag about that every day.
It was so. It was like this tall.
Was it one of those like 600 pound pumpkins?
It was huge. It was like this tall, and then I tried to carve it, and I like there was only one knife thick enough to cut through it, and I was like, this is terrible.
I like
making jokes. I couldn't really carve it. I did get a hole in the top, and then I was like, well, I'm gonna take all the seeds out. At least I'm gonna make pumpkin seeds, so I have some fucking pumpkin seeds to eat. So that's what I did with it.
Well, where was this? Whose prize was a pumpkin?
I think it was like, you know, I grew up in the country on a farm. I think it was like maybe Agway.
Agway? I don't even know what Agway is.
What? You don't know what an Agway is? Oh,
what is Agway?
Man, I'm so country. You can buy feed and seed and, you know, farm stuff.
Oh, I don't
tractor
know.
Parts, I... maybe. Maybe not tractor parts. Like feed and seed and stuff for your farm.
Oh, well, okay. I don't know.
That's true. Why would you know what an Agway
was? I don't know. I'm not going on too many farming stories. But there's nothing
baby,
wrong
they
with
have,
that.
They
I mean,
have
I'm
baby
sure
chicks if you want to raise chickens.
Oh, I love when you can see the little... Oh, anyway.
Yeah, they have a whole bunch of the baby chicks.
I mean, I'm sure you guys don't know about like Restroom World, like the bathroom magazine that my dad used to subscribe to, but like...
No, I don't.
So it's like I don't know. It's not that.
But yes, I didn't know there was a Restroom World.
Yeah, that was a really stupid magazine.
My dad drove truck for a while. He was tractor trailer driver, and you get these magazines about trucks, and there'd be like all these like sexy women laying on the like tractor trailers and stuff, and the centerfold lady.
I'm honestly, I don't know why I'm surprised, but I'm kind of surprised. I pictured that there was a lot of like lady truck drivers.
There are not. There's some, I'm sure.
I was gonna say I've known at least 2. That's yeah. So sad. Third shit. That seems like crazy.
Yeah, the world is unbalanced.
Kitten should drive a truck.
No, the kitten should not.